केमिस्ट्री ग्रीन्स, माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर सादिया तसेरा फ्रॉम फिजियोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट FRPMC. इन दिस प्रैक्टिकल वी आर गोइंग टू रिकॉर्ड द नर्व कंडक्शन एंड कैलकुलेट द नर्व कंडक्शन वेलोसिटी बाय यूजिंग पावर लैब. टू मेजर रिस्पॉन्सेज इवोक्ड बाय द मीडियल नर्व स्टिमुलेशन एट द रिस्ट एंड एट द एल्बो. The latency is longer at the elbow than those evoked by stimulation at the wrist. To calculate the nerve conduction velocity, you need the difference in latencies. All setup is similar to EMG practical. After recording from the wrist, follow the following steps. Position the stimulus bar electrode on the medial aspect of the front of the elbow. The electrode requires firmer pressure at the elbow than at the wrist because the nerve is deeper in the tissues. The orientation of the electrode should be same as for the wrist stimulation, with the red dot position closest to the elbow. Turn the stimulator switch on. The procedure: set the current in the stimulator panel to 8 mA. Click start every time you wish to stimulate. Do this several times using these low amplitude pulses to help find the best position for the electrode. Once you have found the best position for the bar stimulus electrode, increase the stimulus to 15 to 20 milliampere. Click start, repeat several times, turn the stimulator switch off. Now remove the stimulus electrode and mark with a pen the electrode indentation in the skin nearest to the hand. Remove the other electrodes. Analysis: measure and record the distance between the marks at the elbow and the wrist. This is the distance between the stimulation sites. Use the same step as outlined for the wrist stimulation to measure the latency of a single waveform in the lab tutor panel. Record the latency value in the table. This is how you are going to analyze and do the observation. Now students, we are going to measure the responses evoked by the nerve stimulation at the elbow. The latency of these responses is longer than those evoked by stimulation at the wrist. By this, you will be able to calculate the nerve conduction velocity from the difference in the latencies. To calculate the nerve conduction velocity, position the bar stimulus electrode on the medial aspect of the elbow and put the white and black electrodes on the abductor pollicis brevis. The position of the green electrode would be beneath the dry strap. Now we will set the current in the stimulator panel to 8 milliampere and then we will click start. We will do this procedure several times using low amplitude pulses to help find the position of the electrode for the electrode. Okay, once you have found the best position for the bar stimulus electrode, increase the stimulus to 15 to 20 milliampere, click start and repeat the procedure several times. Then turn off the stimulator switch. Now remove the stimulus electrode and mark with a pen on the indentation. Now remove the other electrodes and also mark here. Now students, we will measure and record the distance between the marks at the elbow and at the wrist. This is the distance between the stimulation site.
Use these steps for resistor simulation to measure the latency of a single waveform in the lab tutor panel. Record the latency value in the table.